Hello and welcome to Taboretum channel. You might remember an episode on mastering watertight 3D prints. In one of the comments, you asked for exact parameters, how to actually apply all my hints. So today we will be playing with PrusaSlicer and also Bambu Studio to see how can we set up all these parameters. And this is a super simple shape. It's simply a cone, cut cone, and we will print it in a spiral or vase mode, and we will set settings so it will be watertight. I will start with the ND5 profile for 0.4 millimeter nozzle, generic PLA filament settings, and 0.2 millimeter normal print settings. Okay, let's start with the print settings, and I'm in the expert mode. If we go to the beginner mode, we will not have all the parameters we need. And if you struggle to find something, and there's a lot of options here, you have the search functionality here, which is super useful. So you say spiral or vase, spiral, vase, vertical shells. And you will get to exactly the place you want to be. So it's in layers and parameters, vertical shells, spiral vase. We check this checkbox, and now the tool will itself change some parameters to make them useful for the vase mode. We say yes. And now what we will do here, we will go to the advanced tab and we will set the width to 150%, and we are only interested in parameters and external parameters or the wall width, and let's make it 150% of 0.4 nozzle will be 0.6 for these two, 0.6. So that's the width. I also mentioned that we should reduce the speed. So let's, for the parameters, let's go down, like, let's say 15. And we change all these settings, so we don't need to go extreme, but all these will actually influence the watertightness of our prints. We possibly could go lower with the layer, actual layer height, but I will stick to 0.2 because I don't want to wait too long, but you can go to 0.16 or something like that. And one more parameter that we have, and honestly I don't remember where it is, so I will just search for it again. Overlap. That's the overlap between the infill and parameters, because the tricky part will be the first solid layers. And I will go as high as 35% with this one. So we have lower speed, wider line, and bigger overlap, and potentially small layer height. And these are all changes in the print settings. We can compare them. Let's see, this is the original one, and let's take the modified version. And you can see that we have the extrusion width that is higher, we have more overlap, we are printing slower, and the bottom ones are just for the spiral thing. So we don't have any infill, we have just one parameter. Spiral is set to true, and we don't have any top solid layers. So that's it. And now we have a few changes on the filament side. We will go slightly higher with the temperature, so we'll say that for the other layers next to the first one, we also stick to 210, so we'll go slightly above. We will, in filament overrides, we will disable retraction, so we avoid any gaps that might be there. There is also somewhere here the flow rate, and again, I don't remember where it is, so I'm going to search for it. The flow rate, it's called, I think, multiplier, extrusion multiplier, it's not the flow rate, and it's 1, and we will set it to 1.1, so it means that we will extrude 10% more filament. So we will be over extruding basically to close all the potential gaps. And one more thing we can do, which depends on the type of plastic, but just to give you an option, you can also reduce the cooling fan, right? Because it also will help with bonding of the layers. So now if we compare our modified PLA, you can see that we increased the extrusion multiplier, so the flow rate by 10%. We slightly increased the temperature. We disabled retraction on the filament level, not to change it on the printer level, and we decreased slightly cooling. So all the parameters that I've mentioned in the previous video are now set. So if we go to the platter and we slice it, we end up with something like a pot, and it is a pot because I plan another episode requested by one of the viewers that he is struggling with using prints as actual pot for plants, because when he puts soil in watertight prints, they start to leak, and I want to investigate that. And now if we change in the legend, if we go to the width, you can see that all that is our 0.6, and at the bottom we are at 0.4. So these first layers will be printed at 0.4, and the spiral part will be 0.6, which will make it stiffer. And that's it. And now the tricky part, because I'm seeing Bambu Studio for the first time in my life. This is the same cone shape of the pot, and we have Ender 5 with 0.4 nozzle, a generic PLA filament. Let's this time start with a slightly smaller layer height. Let's make it 0.16, so we change each and every parameter. Then we probably need to go to the advanced mode. And here is the outer wall width. I think this should do the trick, so let's make it 0.6. So that's the second parameter. We need to lower the speed. Outer wall is 40, let's make it 20. And we also need this overlap, and again, not sure where it is, so let's use this magic search button, because it's also here. So it will probably be also called infill wall overlap. So this one uses wall rather than perimeter, which is fine. And here is our infill wall overlap. Let's make it 35%. So these were the four parameters on the process level here, and now let's go to the filament. And what we do here, we want to change the temperature. Oh, it's already high, but let's still change it so you can see. Let's make it 225-ish, but it's already on the high side, high end. So that's the temperature. Setting overrides, retraction, length. If we make it 0, it will disable the retraction, so we disable the retraction. Now we should increase the flow rate and decrease the cooling. So let's decrease the cooling, let's make it max fan speed, and let's make it 80, like before. Ah, sorry, this one is time of a layer. So we reduce the maximum fan speed, and we want to increase the flow rate, and I have no clue where it is, so let's search. And it will be again flow rate, okay, flow ratio, it's called here, and it is here, 0.98, so it's below 1, and we want to make it 1.1. Yeah, and that's it, we set all the parameters. Now we have a different profile and we have a different filament profile, and you unfortunately you can set everything in the process profile, so you need to probably store your filament as the, if we want to save it, we can rename it and call it vase mode, filament vase mode, and we can do the same with the process name. Yeah, let's close these and we can save this one as a vase mode, and it looks super similar to PrusaSlicer. So you see I didn't have much problem with finding all the features, and let's slice it. Okay, so the spiral mode, we didn't turn it on, so as you can see it's full. So that's the one thing that I missed. Don't know where it is, so let's search for it. Either spiral or vase, special mode. Oh, it's in the others. So we click spiral, yes, change settings, and slice. And yeah, it looks okay-ish now, and we can check the line width. Yeah, and this pink thing at the bottom is 0.4, and the rest that is a spiral is 0.6. So that's how you set all these parameters for watertight prints in Bambu Studio. And it says it will print for 1 hour 21 minutes and will use 11.39 grams of filament. So let's just print it. Here you can see the print process. Nothing interesting. Basically, it's a spiral thing with single wall, and that's it. And let's take it to the kitchen and pour in some water and see if it is watertight. Yeah, as you can see, the thing is watertight. This is actually a second try because I filled it with water and it stayed for like 3 hours. And no leak at all. So it works as expected. You know now how to set up your slicer to do watertight prints. And I will be super happy to see your ideas if you print some containers, watering cans, pots for your flowers or whatever. So please put your comments and your designs and your prints in comments below. Please subscribe and thank you very much for watching. Happy printing. Bye bye.